हेलो चिल्ड्रन, आई एम बैक विद एक्सरसाइज 1.2 एक्सप्लेनेशन बिकॉज PDF ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेंट यू. नाउ आई नो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम द PDF इटसेल्फ, बट इट वुड बी ईजियर फॉर दोज हु आर स्लो लर्नर्स, राइट? नाउ आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ Exercise 1.2 is related to integers, right? Addition or subtraction of integers. As per the rule, as I had explained you earlier, that when two integers are added, if one of the integer is negative and the other one is positive, you subtract and then the answer takes up the sign of the bigger number. Here sum number A, or first sum under question number 1, you can see minus 14 plus 7. 14 is negative, 7 is positive. We are adding it. Here it is given sum because plus sign is put, so we are adding the two integers. But finally, what are we doing? When one is negative integer, the other one is positive, we subtract it. And the answer which we get, 14 minus 7 is 7. And answer is carrying negative sign because 14 is bigger and it's having negative sign. Okay? So it's all about adding and subtracting the integers in exercise 1.2. Question 1 tells you to write down the pair of integers in different cases. Okay? The first case is sum is minus 7. You have to pick up two integers whose answer on adding will be negative 7. See, there can be many pairs. Okay? I have put up three examples, three pairs in front of you. You can write any one pair, so the answer will be correct. The condition is that when you add those two integers, you should get a negative integer as answer, right? So here you can see the first pair which I have taken, minus 14 and 7. As it is given, the sum of the taken two integers or given two integers will be negative. And you have to take sum of those integers, addition. Sum means addition. So minus 14 plus 7 gives you minus 7. So the first pair is minus 14 and 7. You can also get minus 7 when you add 3 to negative 10. Okay? We have taken here two integers. One is negative 10 and the other one is 3. And on adding these two integers, I get negative 7. So the next pair is minus 10 and 3. Or you can also take these two pairs also. These two numbers as a pair also. Sorry. So minus 4 and minus 3. That's negative 4 and negative 3. When you add these both the integers, negative integers, you are sure to get a negative answer, that is minus 7. Another rule from here also you can come to know, when two negative numbers are there, minus 4 and minus 3, you are bound to add these two numbers. So minus 4 and minus 3, when added, I get 4 plus 3 is 7 and minus sign is put in front of it. So another pair also you can take, that is minus 4 and minus 3. Out of these three pairs, you can write any one pair. I have just written these three pairs to tell you that you cannot stick to one pair which I give you. You can take any pair, but the condition is on adding those two integers, you get minus 7 as an answer. Clear? Now we move to the second sum. Here you have to take pair of two integers whose difference gives you minus 10. Okay? difference means subtraction. So first pair which I have taken is minus 5 and 5. First integer is minus 5. Then the minus sign stands for difference, and the next integer I have taken is 5, positive 5. So minus 5 and minus 5 gives you minus 10, right? Here you can see minus 6 minus 4 gives you minus 10. So which are the two integers I have taken in the pair? It's minus 6 and positive 4. Is that clear? Here the minus sign stands for the term difference. Clear to you? So the integers which we have taken is negative 6 and positive 4. Is that clear to you? It's like this. Negative 6 and positive. So you can see any pair you can take whose difference gives you minus 10. Here you have to take next pair whose sum is 0. So as you know, when you add additive inverse to the original number, when you add additive inverse to its original number, what do you get? You get 0. So you can take any pair. Like I have taken here minus 20 plus 20. What does it give you? 0. Minus 1 plus 1 gives you 0. So two pairs like this, you can take any pair where you get the sum 0. Question number 2. Write a pair of negative integers whose difference gives 8. Now here it is specified. You have to take integers but with the given condition. Here you have to take a pair of negative integers. You have to take two integers that are negative. And on finding their difference, taking their difference, you get positive 8. So you have choice over here. You cannot take any pairs. So let's see which pairs can give 8 as answer in their difference. Okay, here I have taken minus 2 and minus 10. And the difference, so this minus sign between both the integer is for the difference. On simplifying, negative negative becomes positive. And so minus 2 plus 10. One is negative integer, the other one 10 is positive after simplifying. So what are you going to do? You are going to subtract, and it will take up the positive sign by default because 10 is bigger than 2. So 8 is the answer, and the pair is of two integers, that is negative 2 and negative 10. Okay, we move on to the next sum of question number 2. Write a negative and a positive integer whose sum is minus 5. Here is a pair which consists of a negative and a positive integer. So I have taken negative 10 and 5. On adding, I am getting minus 5. Minus 5, which is the required answer. So the pair consists of minus 10 and 5. And the third one in question number 2 is write a negative and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. You have to take one integer negative, the other one positive. And here you don't have to take the sum, but you have to take difference. So I have taken minus 1 and 2. And the difference will be minus 3. Because as I had told you, when two negative numbers are there, you add up those integers and the final answer carries negative sign, and that's minus 3. as per the requirement. Okay, now we move on to question number 3. The sums are very easy. Here you are playing with the integers, that is negative and positive numbers, and nothing you are doing. You are just going to add or subtract as per the question's demand. Now, third question tells, in a quiz, team A scored minus 40, 10, 0, and team B scored 10, 0, minus 40. In three successive rounds, which team scored more? Can we say that we can add integers in any order? To tell this, we have to first add up the scores scored by team A and B separately. Okay, so scores of team A minus 4, 10, 0. Total scores of team, I'm going to add up the scores of team A. Minus 40 plus 10 plus 0 gives you minus 30. Negative 40 plus 10, subtract and put the negative sign in front of 30. Okay, though the operation here is addition, but the integers are, one is negative and the other one is positive. Finally, we subtract to get the answer. So as we take the scores of team B, 10, 0, minus 40, total scores of team B, add up the scores and we get 10 minus 40, subtracting bigger number from the smaller one, as usual, you get a negative answer. Again, the answer is minus 30. Both the answers you can compare, both are same, equal. Only the difference you can see is while adding the scores where the order of the scores are different. In the case of team A, in the first round it scored negative 40, second round 10 and third round 0. Whereas in the scores of team B, you can see first round it scored 10, second round 0, and in the third round it scored negative 40. That is, the order of the scores have changed. So as per the commutativity, even if the order changes, the final score or the sum of the score remains the same. So we can conclude that we can add integers in any order. See question 4, fill in the blanks. Here these blanks will remind you about the properties which you have studied for whole number and natural numbers. Similarly, these properties also stand true for integers. Now here you can see the first blank. Minus 5 plus minus 8 is equal to minus 8 plus dash. There I have written minus 5 because it follows commutative property for addition. Okay, and it tells that any two integers can be added in any order, the answer remains same. Negative 5 plus negative 8 gives you negative 13, and if you change the order, first you write negative 8 and then you take negative 5, answer you will get negative 13. In both the cases answer remains same, so it supports commutativity. Okay, now second one, minus 53 plus dash is equal to minus 53. This is 0 as a neutral number for addition. When you add 0 to any number, any integer, you get that same integer as an answer. So what did I put? Looking at the blank, I found towards the left hand side minus 53 is added to a certain number, and the answer I am getting on the right hand side is minus 53. So which number gives you the same integer? That is 0. So 0 as a neutral number for addition, so I have put 0 in the blank. Now here you move on to third, fill in the blanks. When do you get 0 as an answer? When you add additive inverse to its original number. Okay? Or when you add an integer to its additive inverse, you get 0. What is additive inverse of an integer? Integer agar positive hai, uska additive inverse negative ho jayega. Aur agar negative hai integer, to uska additive inverse kya hoga? Positive. So the sign changes. And when we add an integer to its additive inverse, the answer is always 0. So looking at the fill in the blanks, 17 plus dash gives you 0. Then it should click immediately that when do you get 0 as an answer? When you put its additive inverse. So what is the additive inverse of 17? It's minus 17. So I put minus 17 in the blank. Move on to the next fill in the blanks. The next fill in the blanks tells you about associative rule or associative property for addition of integers. When more than two integers are taken for addition, what do? You don't add all the integers together? No. We first make a group of two. Okay? So here you can see towards the left hand side, I have grouped first 13 and minus 12. And then after adding those two integers, I'm going to add its answer to minus 7. That will be equal to adding up the last two integers first, and the answer we add it to the first integer 13. Right? So we have a blank over here, fill in the blanks over here, statement over here, which I can prove it by giving you the answer. 13 plus minus 12 is first added towards the left hand side, plus minus minus. So 13 minus 12 is 1, and 1 plus minus 7 is minus 6. Same thing over here, minus 12 plus minus 7 gives you minus 19, negative 19. When you solve these two numbers, you will get negative 19. And negative 19 plus 13, that means one is positive, the other one is negative, you subtract and you get minus 6. In both the cases, I get negative 6. So this proves associative property for addition of integers, right? So as per the associative property, when I go through this statement, what is the answer you are going to write here? For that, you have to check the right hand side part of the expression, and I can find that 13, 12, and what is missing? Minus 7 is missing here, so I will write minus 7 in this blank. Now we move on to the next fifth fill in the blanks. Here you can see the same associative property. Here 15 and minus 3 is grouped first, and in the next part minus blank is given here. So you can compare both the side, minus 4, minus 4, 15, 15. What is missing? Minus 3 is missing here, so write here minus 3. So here is the end of your exercise 1.2.